kwa awamu nyingine mtazamaji na msikilizaji wa channel ya kwetu ya The FM Show KE, na kukaribisha awamu nyingine ambapo tunakwenda kuzungumzia maisha ya mwenda zake Archbishop Amos Kabodo, ambaye ndiye alikuwa ameshikilia ushukani kama bishop mkuu, Archbishop mkuu katika kanisa la Independent, ama ukipenda kanisa la AIPCA, African Independent Church. Na ileo mwili wake Archbishop Amos Kabodo unapatwa kulazwa kule nyumbani kwao katika eneo la Nyeri. Ila kando na uongozi wake katika kanisa la AIPCA, nataka tuzungumzia soa uanzili Kabodo kuwa yeye ndiye mwanzilishi kabisa wa vita na mtafaruku ulioweza kuzuka kwa muda mrefu katika uongozi wa kanisa la AIPCA. Now, mkiniruhusu ni badili ndimi kidogo. Amepata kupumzika Archbishop Kabodo. Ni kweli tulimpenda, ni kweli tulimwenzi. Lakini kwa sasa nataka tuzungumzia soa one of the many things that have been spoken about in regards to his leadership at the AIPCA church. Now, an article was published in the year 2017 after Archbishop Amos Kabodo handed over church leadership to Frederick Wang'ombe on February 5th, 2017 at the church's headquarters in Bahati, Nairobi. Now, a leadership rago in the African Independent Pentecostal Church of Africa, AIPCA, continued to intensify further after Kabodo handed over to the newly elected successor amid strong opposition from church members. The retired Archbishop handed over to Bishop Frederick Wang'ombe, who was elected by some of the church bishops from across the country then. Another leader, Bishop Julius Njoroge, was elected by a rival group on January 9th and was due for official inauguration. Now, the election of the two spiritual leaders by the two opposing groups divided the church, with Archbishop Kabodo's supporters calling the arrivals a splinter group. In July 2016, the High Court ordered Archbishop Kabodo to retire while the church was directed to hold elections for a new head, while adding over power to Bishop Wang'ombe at the AIPCA headquarters in Bahati, Nairobi County. Archbishop Kabodo said he had accepted to leave his position in good faith and allow the new leader to take over. AIPCA then Acting Secretary General Simon Maina Kimaru said the church would not accept any elected leader other than Wang'ombe. And I shall quote him, the AIPCA church as one archbishop. If there is any other archbishop, we do not acknowledge them, he told the congregation. According to Mr. Kimaru, before Sunday's ceremony, then the two opposing sides held an overnight meeting to reach an agreement, but their negotiation bore no fruit. Archbishop Wang'ombe called for an end to the fight that had bedeviled the church for a very long time, and he settled the ragos that had started off at the AIPCA church. But the man of God, Archbishop Kabodo, was termed as the man that brought the fight inside the AIPCA church. Remember, he rested a few days ago, and today he is being buried, he is being rested. Yeah, as we speak as of right now, the Deputy President of the Republic of Kenya is among those that have attended the burial of Archbishop Amos Kabodo. Yeah, and that's what's up. What do you have to say? What is your take? Because as we speak, kanisa la AIPCA kwa sasa lipo chini ya bishop fulani hivi kutokea katika eneo la Meru County, ambaye ndiye anaongoza kanisa la AIPCA. But before that, there was an election that was held where Archbishop Wang'ombe was contesting against this archbishop, I think Mureithi or somebody. Yeah, but Mureithi won against Wang'ombe, and Wang'ombe was overthrown as the archbishop of the AIPCA churches. All we can say right now is may the great man of God rest in eternal power. But you know what? Sometimes kanisa huja na mambo mingi sana. Mara nyingi mnajipata uongozi unawatenganisha. Pesa utajiri, umaarufu, vyote vinakuwa kizingiti kikubwa sio katika kueneza injili. The man, the legend, the don, Amos Kabodo has rested. May he rest in eternal peace. One pillar of the AIPCA church has left the universe. Make sure you subscribe to FM Show KE. Tutaungana katika video zetu zijazo. Usisahau. Mimi ni Felix Mwenda.